Welcome back to the wind tunnel. We've seen time and time again that making the right aero choice, whether it's wheels, helmets, frames, and even body positioning, can result in massive time savings. Now, the story doesn't just end at narrow as aero. These things all are shaped to fully maximize and take advantage of crosswinds as well. So to demonstrate that point, I'm gonna hop in the tunnel on my shiv, both in a straight headwind. We're gonna turn it into a crosswind and demonstrate how those results change.
So Chris, what'd it feel like in there?
Felt awesome having the full-on aero gear, but I'm really just curious about how that crosswind point did compared to the head-on.
So if you compare that head-on point with the crosswind point, you're about 7% faster in the crosswind with all your aero gear.
So with the 40K time trial, if there were a dead crosswind, it'd be something like 68 seconds faster over that distance. It's crazy. We just saw that with a full aero setup, even in a moderate crosswind, there's a significant savings. Now we've seen a lot of the same results with an aero road bike and an aggressive position there. And when you go to a more traditional road bike, it may even be slower in that crosswind. Now in this video, we showed you what happens in that crosswind. In a later video, we'll try to explain exactly how it works. Thanks again for all your great questions. Please continue submitting them through Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, hashtag AeroEsEverything, and continue to subscribe to our specialized YouTube channel. Thanks.